www.decibelz.com.
Hi, this is Atul Kocher. For news, gossip and gupshup, check out decibelz.com.
Hi, this is Faisal from decibelz.com. And our guest for today is British-based chef, restaurateur, and television personality, Atul Kocher.
Hello, Faisal.
Hello, Atul. How are you doing?
Very good, and you?
Fine, thanks. Atul, can you please tell us, when did you start your cooking career?
Faisal, I think cooking started pretty much when I was born. Let's put it this way, because I was born in a family who was surrounded by food. My dad had a catering business. My granddad was a baker. So it was only natural for me to slip into the same trade, even if they wanted me to be a doctor.
I'll add one red chili, which is actually sealed from both the ends, and that is just to draw the flavor out.
What kind of cuisine did you grow up with?
When I was growing up, it was pretty much a desi cuisine, you know, mom's food and dad's rich food. Once in a while, the treat was to go for Chinese, or once in a while, street food. Street food was always part of growing up. But yes, mainly, desi khana.
So I can assume that you were eating all this chatpate khane as growing up?
Absolutely. I was all into it. And the ritual was very simple. Dad would come home in the evening. We would be the bag carriers. So we will follow him into the markets. We'll have a bit of snack from the street food, buy vegetables for the day, go home. Mum would cook, have our dinner, and hit the bed. So that was kind of everyday ritual. So street food is a kind of very nostalgic food moments of my life.
How did the critically acclaimed Benares restaurant and bar come about and get started?
I was working for a restaurant called Tamarind. That's where I had got my first Michelin star. And I decided that I work for other people for a very long time now, and it's time that I start my own. And I found two wealthy friends who came and gave me a helping hand to open the restaurant. And that's how I kick-started. And the aim was simple, singular, straightforward aim, that we wanted to be a best restaurant in London, not just Indian, and that's what we have achieved.
What would you say is the success behind the restaurant Benares?
The success behind Benares is its consistency when it comes to its product, its offering, and also the sheer hard work of my team, and I can't thank them enough for this. It's a total teamwork, and I feel very privileged to be the captain of that ship.
You definitely are a captain of a ship, because you've established a restaurant on P&O's Azura cruise ship. What kind of cuisine do you offer at sea?
On the ship, I offer very simple, straightforward, eclectic Indian food. It's obviously mélangé with British ingredients and the nouvelle techniques. So quite good cuisine, I would say, but very robust and straightforward flavors when it comes to our desi khana. And people seem to enjoy that. I have to say that. When I made that restaurant, I had no idea how I'm going to achieve it. But when the results started coming out, I feel very proud that we have that restaurant.
Any plans to open a restaurant in Jamshedpur, the city you were born in? Or maybe somewhere even remote, maybe the Arctic Ocean?
I haven't thought of opening a restaurant in Jamshedpur. This is the first time somebody has asked me whether I would ever open a restaurant. Yes, it's a thought. The remotest I have gone is Mauritius, and I have a restaurant there which I've just recently opened, and I don't think I'm thinking of Antarctica or Arctic Ocean as you're suggesting, but if polar bear becomes savvy, then I might be opening a restaurant.
Any plans for further restaurants across the globe?
I have just opened a small restaurant in Bromley called Indian Essence, and that's a family-owned restaurant. We own it, and family kind of would run it as well. And that was always the aim, to do it, and I've just landed up doing it. Yes, the aim is to conquer the world. Let's see what happens.
Kindly share with our viewers one healthy food tip of your own.
Eat as much as you need. Don't indulge. You will be healthy for your life. The problem comes from indulging. When we just overdo things, that's when food becomes unhealthy. If you look back in the old times, people had heavy, hearty meals because they had to walk a lot. They had to work in farms. They had to do all kinds of physical work. These days, we have continued to have the same meal, but we step out of our houses, sit in our Rolls Royce, go to our offices, plush offices, sit on those big fat chairs, look at the computer screens all day, come back home and have another hearty meal and sleep. We don't do any exercise. We just forget about it, that we need to kind of keep fit. You want to indulge, but you know what? go to the gym, go for a run, walk, do hard work as well to burn those calories, and you'll be fine.
What's it about fish that you love most?
One thing which I love about fish is it's such a neutral and gentle ingredient, and you have to treat it with care, love and affection. We, as Indian cuisine, we overdo it and kill the fish twice. And that's what I hate about my own culture or my own cuisine, I would say. So I'm trying to kind of drag it out and say it's one of the gentlest ingredient nature has provided. Let's give it a little more care.
Besides fish, name a few of your favorite dishes.
I am very much into season. I grew up in a country where refrigeration was a little remote concept. So you had to rely on whatever was available in the season. So I have just kept my same trend and I do that. So I enjoy my hearty food during autumn, winter, and light, gentle food through spring and summer. And that's how I maintain my menus.
Do you like to experiment when it comes to cooking?
I experiment. My R&D is on 24/7. It's something which, as a human, you have to constantly do that. You evolve. So when I migrated to this country, obviously I wasn't going to get things like okra and the white pumpkin and pomfrey for that matter. So I had to dip into British ingredients and look for sea bass, monkfish, turnip which are grown here, Swedes, salsify, the vegetables which are unheard of. So I had to experiment with them and make them Indian-esque, and that's what I do.
Do you cook at home or do you leave it to the missus?
I generally leave it to the missus. She's a great cook and I love her food, and it'll be a shame not just to keep imposing my cooking on her.
Finally, do you have any advice for budding chefs?
They should keep their R&D on. There's every opportunity they can learn something new, they should go for it and keep their head down, keep working hard, and that's the way to look at it. Hi, this is Atul Kocher. Keep watching DesiBlitz.com.